So in this section, we're going to use some of what we learned about like terms and expressions and things like that to solve some equations that are a little bit more difficult than the ones we already learned. So this is going to be solving equations, and we're going to review the addition and multiplication properties of equality as well. So first, let's recall the addition property of equality, which we already talked about. And the addition property of equality says, if you remember, that if we have an equation with both sides being equal, I can add the same number to both sides, and then both sides of the equation are still equal. Similarly, I can also subtract the same number from both sides. So I can take a minus c and b minus c, and that equal sign is still true. Both sides of the equation are still going to be worth the same. That's the addition property of equality. There's also the multiplication property of equality, and that one says that, again, given an equation with two equal sides, I can multiply both sides by the same number, and the equation still holds, or I can divide both sides by the same numbers, and the equation is still going to hold. So we're going to use these properties in combination with what we know. So let's do a couple of examples from a few sections ago just to recall what we already know. So remember, we wanted to do something like x plus 6 equals negative 1 minus 3, and I wanted to solve for x. One of the things I need to do before I even start is simplify the right side of the equation, because that's not simplified. So when I do that, I get negative 4. And then I'm going to use the addition property of equality to isolate x. So I'm going to subtract 6 from both sides. When I do that, I end up with x equals negative 10. And I can check if I did everything correctly by going back to the original problem and plugging in negative 10 for x, and then seeing if both sides are equal. So negative 10 plus 6 is negative 4, and negative 1 minus 3 is also negative 4. So since both sides are equal, I know I did that correctly. You should make sure you understand by doing some of the following examples. So some of the examples are, for example, 10 equals 2m minus 4m. So in this example, you would have to combine, you would have to combine the m's and then solve for m. Another example is negative 6y minus 1 plus 7y equals 17 plus 2. So in this example, you would combine like terms on the left, combine like terms on the right, and then solve for y. Let me give you a different example, which we have 4 minus 10. Equals 4y minus 5y, same thing, simplify the left, simplify the right, and I'll do 1 for you, I'll do d for you, in which we have 13x equals 4 times 3x minus 1. So I'm going to start by simplifying the right side of the equation. So to simplify the right side, I need to use a distributive property. So I am left with 12x minus 4. So the right side is simplified. Now I need to solve the equation for x. So one of the things I can do here is I have x's on both sides. So let me get that 12x over to the left by using the addition property of equality. So if I subtract 12x from both sides, my 12x's are going to cancel out, and I'm going to be left with 13x minus 12x. That's going to give me a 1x equals negative 4. So x equals negative 4, that's exactly what I expected. So I could stop there. So now that we know how to work with these, let's go ahead and talk about combining the properties of equality when we have more than one property. So to combine the properties of equality, let's say we have a problem that's 5y plus 2 equals 17. Remember, our goal in all these problems is to get the variable by itself. So in this case, it's to get y equals some number. So the first thing we're going to do is we are going to try to isolate the y by using the addition property of equality. So to do that, I'm going to subtract 2 from both sides, and I'm going to be left with 5y equals 17 minus 2, and 17 minus 2 is 15, then I'm going to use the multiplication property of equality. 2 divide both sides by 5, and I get y equals 3. We can check if this is correct by plugging in 3 into y. And I get 15 plus 2 equals 17. 15 plus 2 is actually 17, so my answer is correct. So the key here is to first use the addition property of equality as much as you can, and then go into the multiplication property of equality. So let's try another example. Let's try negative 4 times x plus 2 minus 60 equals 2 minus 10. So let me write the steps down, actually, to make it a little bit easier. So step one should be to simplify the left and right sides individually. Then you should use the addition property of equality as much as you can. And finally, use the multiplication property of equality as much as you can. So let's start by simplifying the left. So to simplify the left, I need to distribute this negative 4x, this negative 4 into x and 2. So I'm simplifying the left here. And when I do that, I get negative 4x minus 8 minus 60 equals 2 minus 10. I still need to simplify the left a little more. If I combine negative 8 and negative 60, so I end up with negative 4x minus 68 equals 2 minus 10. So I'm done simplifying the left. Now let me simplify the right. 2 minus 10 simplifies out to be negative 8. Okay, now that I'm done, now let me use the addition property of equality. I want to isolate x, so I'm going to add 68 to both sides. When I do that, my negative 68 and 68 cancel out, and I'm left with negative 4x equals negative 8 plus 68. That's positive 60. Then the last thing I'm going to do is I'm going to use the multiplication property of equality and divide both sides by negative 4. That will isolate x for me. So when I do that, I'm left with x equals 60 divided by negative 4. And that's going to be 15. Negative 15, sorry. Okay, and let me just verify that. So to verify that, all I'm going to do is that I'm going to plug in 15 into the original equation for x. So it's negative 4 times negative 15 plus 2 minus 60 equals 2 minus 10. So I went back over to the original equation, which is right here, and plugged in negative 15 for x. Now let's see if everything checks out. So according to the order of operations, I have to do negative 15 plus 2 first. Negative 15 plus 2 is negative 13. Bring everything else down. Negative 4 times negative 13 is a positive 52. Minus 60 equals 2 minus 10. And then when I subtract these two, 52 minus 60 gives me negative 8. And 2 minus 10 also gives me negative 8. So because both sides are equal, I know that I did the problem correctly. There's a lot more problems like this in your textbook. Another thing you might be asked to do is to translate word problems into expressions. Into expressions or equations. So in your book, there's a whole table of different keywords you can use for this. I'm just going to go over a few examples. So let's say you're given the sum of negative 3 and a number. So this is an expression, and it's an expression because there's no equal sign. And they want to know the sum. Remember that keyword sum means plus. So they want the sum between negative 3 and a number. A number is, we're just going to call x. You can use any variable you want. So the sum between negative 3 and a number would just be negative 3 plus x. Let's try another one where we have negative 5 decreased by a number. So we have negative 5, whatever negative 5 is, and we're decreasing that by a number, x. So that would look like negative 5 minus x. Let's try a number subtracted from -83. So we know subtracted means minus. The problem is, which of these is your minuend and which of these is your subtrahend? Is a number your minuend, or is 83 your minuend and which is the subtrahend? Well, if we're subtracting from 83, remember 83 then would be your minuend. The first number, the number you're subtracting for, is your minuend. The subtrahend would then be x. So that translates to 83 minus x. A lot of people make the mistake of flipping these two, not in this case. Let me try one more. The quotient of a number and negative 4. And what I wanted to point out here is that that word quotient is a key word for division. So when I ask for the quotient of a number and negative 4, I mean x divided by negative 4. I can also write this as x over negative 4, because that bar in there is called a fraction bar, and it means division.